We're at the Jones Center at Ichauway. We're a nearly 29,000 acre property in South Georgia in Baker County. At the Jones Center, we conduct a lot of research. The research centers around longleaf pine and its associated wildlife and water resources. The coastal plain is one of the best places for longleaf pine because it has the right types of soils and terrain that you tend to see longleaf pine in. However, longleaf pine can be found in some of the lower levels of mountains, including North Georgia. Pine is a very popular timber product because, for the most part, they grow faster than a lot of other tree species. They're also very useful at younger stages for things like pulpwood that can create paper and paper products. Pines are what we call conifers. Conifers are trees that are evergreen that hold on to their leaves throughout the year, as opposed to deciduous trees like oaks, which will drop their leaves in the fall or in early winter. The longleaf pine cycle begins when a seed drops from a cone from a mature tree. That seed then germinates on bare soil, which is where it sprouts its first roots and leaves. It will then enter the grass stage, where it may stay for a number of years, where it resembles a type of grass called bunch grass. Then it will enter the rocket stage. This is a point in time where it grows as fast as possible so it can outcompete other trees in the area, and eventually it will become a mature longleaf pine that will then produce its own cones and seeds. Depending on conditions of the surrounding forest, the longleaf pine seed to mature tree cycle may take as low as 40 years, or it may take as long as 100 years. It depends on how you manage that forest and whether or not you use prescribed fire specifically. Prescribed fire is human set fire with a specific objective. Some of the most common objectives will be to manage a forest for a particular species. For example, the gopher tortoise that needs a very open understory. It needs space to move around on the forest floor, and it needs different foods that are reachable from a tortoise's height. Another example of an objective you would use prescribed fire for is to promote the growth of grasses instead of woody shrubs that then allow for more wildlife species to inhabit the area. You can also speed up the growth of longleaf pine in the grass stage because it clears out competing trees and it allows sunlight to get to those small grass stage pine. At Ichauway, we burn about 12,000 acres a year, and of the 29,000 acres we have, about 90% of it is what we consider burnable acreage. When we're planning our prescribed burning, we only burn certain units of the forest at a time. This allows wildlife to find a shelter as the fire passes through, and then they'll relatively quickly go back into that burned area. By not burning the entire landscape at once, we're able to create more diversity, but also create escapes for wildlife that are mobile.
It's necessary that everybody's aware of the importance of prescribed fire in maintaining forests. One of the important aspects of prescribed fire is the prevention of wildfire. And so when we burn frequently, we're removing fuels every year, so it's less likely to catch on fire and have a catastrophic event. So we just did a prescribed fire last week. It should be starting to green up by now. These plants respond really quickly after a prescribed fire. Basically, you're removing the dead vegetation and the plants will have vigorous regrowth. There's a lot of things that are beneficial from that. There's a fertilization effect that the plants can take advantage of when they regrow. There's some plant species that are dependent on prescribed fire to produce seed, and then fire helps with competition from other species. And so I think it's important that everybody is aware of the importance of prescribed fire.